Very good morning, my dear students. I welcome you all once again for VTU eShikshana program. Today I am continuing next session, that is the 8th session on this thermal radiation module of heat transfer subject. Myself, Dr. Madhukeshwarayan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering Department, Jain Institute of Technology, Davanagere. You can note down my email ID and phone numbers displayed on the screen. And you can contact me for any clarifications or doubts regarding this chapter. In the previous session, we have done some of the examples. In this session also, we'll continue with some more examples for the better understanding of thermal radiation concepts. So the next example is as follows. Liquid oxygen whose boiling temperature is -182 degrees Celsius is to be stored in a spherical container of 30 centimeter diameter. The system is insulated by an evacuated space between inner space and surrounding 45 centimeter inner diameter concentric sphere. For both sphere, emissivity epsilon is 0.03 and temperature of outer sphere is 30 degrees Celsius. Estimate the rate of heat flow by radiation to the oxygen in the container. Determine the rate at which liquid oxygen would evaporate at -182 degrees Celsius. Take latent heat of oxygen as 215 kilojoules per kg. So this is what the example is given. There is a liquid oxygen stored in the spherical container. This spherical container is having a 30 centimeter diameter. This system is insulated by evacuated space between inner space and out surrounding 45 centimeter inner diameter concentric sphere. So there is one more sphere which has the inner diameter of 45 centimeter, and in between them there is a space. For both spheres, inner and outer, inside the inner sphere there is a liquid oxygen, and between inner sphere and outer sphere there is a space. And for both spheres, the emissivity epsilon is 0.03, that is what they have given. And temperature of outer sphere is 30 degrees Celsius. So outer sphere is having a surface temperature of 30 degrees Celsius. So we have to estimate rate of heat flow by radiation to the oxygen in the container. Means from the outer sphere to the inner sphere and then to the liquid oxygen, what will be the heat flow or rate of heat flow that we have to find. Also we have to find rate at which liquid oxygen would evaporate at -182 degrees Celsius. So latent heat of oxygen is given as 215 kilojoules per kg. Now in order to solve this one, we have the following procedure. The heat flow between the two concentric sphere by radiation is given by the equation. This equation is Q1 to 2, means from inside sphere to outside sphere, the rate of heat transfer is equal to A1 into sigma into T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4, whole divided by 1 minus epsilon 1 divided by epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by F1 to 2, that is the shape factor from 1 to 2, plus 1 minus epsilon 2 divided by epsilon 2 into the ratio of areas A1 and A2. This is the schematic of the given example. You can see this is the inside sphere where in this sphere there is a liquid oxygen. That is a cryogenic fluid which is maintained at a temperature of -182 degrees Celsius. The emissivity of this surface is 0.03. So there is an evacuated space between the inside sphere and outside sphere, and the outside sphere is maintained at a temperature of 30 degrees Celsius. Now for concentric sphere, shape factor 1 to 2 is equal to 1, because all the radiation emitted by the inner sphere 1 will be totally absorbed by the outer sphere 2. Therefore F 1 to 2 will be equal to 1. And ratios of areas A1 to A2 is equal to D1 by D2 whole square. This is nothing but pi D1 square by 4 divided by pi D2 square by 4. Pi by 4 in the numerator as well as pi by 4 in the denominator will get cancels, and the remaining will be A1 by A2 ratio will be D1 by D2 to the power of 2. Now, the same equation Q1 to 2 is equal to sigma T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 into A1 whole divided by 1 by epsilon 1 plus area ratios D1 by D2 square into 1 minus epsilon 2 divided by epsilon 2, where T1 is how much? Minus 182 degrees Celsius plus 273 is equal to 91 Kelvin, and T2 is 30 degrees Celsius plus 273 is equal to 303 Kelvin. Area of A1 is area of the sphere 4 pi R1 square. See, diameter is 30 centimeter they have given. Therefore, radius of the inner sphere will become 15 centimeter. That is 4 pi into 15 divided by 100 square, which is equal to 0.8282 meter square. Now substituting the values in the equation A. So now we got T1, T2 and A1. So substituting these values, we will get Q1 to 2 is equal to 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 is there, because I am substituting these values divided by 100 to the power of 4. So that will cancel. Therefore, I can just substitute 5.67 into T1 is here 91 Kelvin, that is 91 by 100 to the power of 4 Kelvin, that is 0.91, minus T2 is 303 divided by 100, that is 3.03 to the power of 4 into 0.282. 0.282 is nothing but area A1. What we have calculated in the earlier section. Now 1 divided by epsilon 1 is 0.03 they have given in the problem. D1 by D2, 30 centimeter divided by 45 centimeter, both are in centimeter, no need to convert into meter, whole square into 1 minus 0.03 divided by 0.03. So which is equal to again 5.67 into 0.686 minus 82.289 into 0.282 divided by 33.3 plus 14.52, which is equal to, since this is a larger value compared to the previous 0.686, the whole term will be negative value, that is minus 5.67 into 81.6 into 0.282 divided by 47.82, which is equal to minus 2.72 watts. The negative sign here indicates that heat flows from the outside to the inside, means heat is flowing from the outer sphere to the inner sphere. So heat transfer takes place from the outside to the inside cryogenic liquid. So this is what the solution for this problem. We'll take one more problem. So the problem is like this. Two circular disks of diameter 20 centimeter each are placed 2 meter apart. Calculate the radiant heat exchange for these disks if they are maintained at 800 degrees Celsius and 300 degrees Celsius respectively, and the corresponding emissivity are 0.3 and 0.5. So there are two disks, and both the disks are having 20 centimeter diameter, and distance between these two disks are 2 meter, and both are maintained at different temperatures of 800 degrees Celsius, 300 degrees Celsius, and emissivities are also different, 0.3 and 0.5. Now we need to find what the radiant heat exchange for these two disks. For that, so heat exchange Q, before that we have to find out A1. A1 is area of disk 1. So disk is nothing but a circle, pi by 4 into D1 square, which is equal to pi by 4 into 0.2 square, which is equal to 0.031 meter square. A1 is equal to 0.031 meter square, which is also equal to A2, because diameter of the two disks are same. So that is the D1 is equal to D2. Heat transfer by radiation generation equation is Q1 to 2 is sigma into T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 whole divided by 1 minus epsilon 1 divided by A1 into epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by A1 into view factor F1 to 2 plus 1 divided by epsilon 2 divided by A2 into epsilon 2, where T1 and T2 are temperatures of disk 1 and 2. Sigma is a Stefan-Boltzmann constant. Epsilon 1 and epsilon 2 are emissivities of surface 1 and 2. A1 and A2 are the areas of disks 1 and 2. Here in this case both are same. A1 is equal to A2 in this case, because the D1 is equal to D2. So now, substituting these values, 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8, that is Stefan-Boltzmann constant, T1 1073 to the power of 4 minus T2 573 to the power of 4 divided by 1 minus epsilon 1 0.3 divided by A1 0.031 into epsilon 1 0.3 plus 1 divided by 0.31, that is A1, into view factor F1 to 2, that is kept as it is because we don't know the value of that one, plus 1 minus 0.5, that is epsilon 2, divided by area A2, which is equal to A1 0.031 into epsilon 2 0.5, which further after simplification in the numerator will be equal to 69 into 10 to the power of 3 divided by 107.45 plus 1 divided by 0.031 into view factor F1 to 2. This is the simplified equation for Q1 to 2. Now, in order to find out F1 to 2, we will use this view factor between two coaxial parallel disks of same diameter. So this is the graph where we can refer this graph to find out the value of F1 to 2. Now, D by L is 0.1. So D by L is equal to 0.1 in this case. So for this 0.1 here, if you go here, we will get F1 to 2 as 0.01 as the answer. So x-axis is this D by L, which is equal to 0.1. There is only one curve. So from this x-axis, go in a upward direction, okay, and then move in a left direction towards the y-axis, and y-axis value is nothing but F1 to 2, which is equal to 0.01. So that same thing what they have given. So F1 to 2 is the shape factor for the disk. In order to find shape factor for the disk F1 to 2, x-axis will be equal to diameter divided by distance between disc, that is 0.2 divided by 2, where x-axis is equal to what? 0.1. x-axis value is 0.1, curve is 1, and corresponding y-axis value is 0.01. Therefore, f1 to 2 is 0.01. Substituting this value here in the previous equation, so we will get q1 to 2 as 69 into 10 to the power of 3 divided by 107.45 plus 1 divided by 0.031 into 0.01, where q1 to 2 we will get 20.7 watts. So similarly, we will solve some more problems. So this is the next example. So this example is like this. A long cylindrical heater 30 millimeter diameter is maintained at 700 degrees Celsius. It has surface emissivity of 0.8. The heater is located in a large room whose wall is 35 degrees Celsius. Find the radiant heat transfer. Find the percentage of reduction in the heat transfer if heater is completely covered by radiation shield with emissivity 0.05 and diameter 40 millimeter. So in this problem, what they have given? So there is a long cylindrical heater of 30 millimeter diameter, which is at a temperature of 700 degrees Celsius. It has an emissivity of 0.8. This heater is located where? It is located in the large room. The wall temperature of the room is 35 degrees Celsius. So find radiant heat transfer. We have to find the radiant heat transfer. Also find percentage of reduction in heat transfer if the heater is completely covered by radiation shield. Suppose if the heater is covered by the radiation shield of 40 millimeter diameter and epsilon 0.05, what is the percentage? What is the percentage reduction in the heat transfer? So that is what we have to find out. So D1 is 0.03 meter, T1 700 degrees Celsius plus 273 Kelvin, epsilon 1 0.8, T2 35 degrees Celsius plus 273, which is equal to 308 Kelvin, radiation shield epsilon 3 0.05 and D3 0.04. Here D1 is for the long cylinder, the suffix 1 represents the long cylinder, the suffix 2 represents the large room, and the suffix 3 represents the radiation shield. Now, heat transfer without shield. Now, we will first assume that there is no shield and we will calculate heat transfer without a shield, that is heat transfer from the heater to the room. The heat transfer by radiation is given by Q1 to 2 is equal to sigma into T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 divided by 1 minus epsilon 1 divided by A1 into epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by A1 into F1 to 2, that is view factor, plus 1 divided by 1 minus epsilon 2 divided by A2 into epsilon 2, where 1 stands for temperature, emissivity and areas of the heater. The suffix 2 stands for temperature, area and emissivities of the room. Here A1 is equal to what? The circumferential area of the heater, that is pi d into L. Pi d is circumference into length. So pi into d for unit length it is considered. Pi into 0.030 into 1 is equal to 0.094 meter. where A1 is equal to 0.094 meter square. This is meter square. Since the room is large, A2 is equal to infinity. So very large room is there. A2 is taken as infinity. Now shape factor F 1 to 2. Small body enclosed by a large body, then F to 2. That is heater, when it is enclosed by a large body, completely all the radiation transfer from the heater to the room. The room will absorb entire radiation. Therefore, F 1 to 2, that is a shape factor from 1 to 2, will become 1. Now, substituting those values, Q1 to 2 is equal to Stefan Boltzmann constant sigma 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 into T1 973 to the power of 4 and T2 that is 308 to the power of 4, 1 minus epsilon 1 divided by A1 into epsilon 1 into 1 minus of epsilon 2 into A1 into F1 to 2 and 0. So this 0 comes here. Since A1 to 2 is 0, is infinity, so here in this ratio the numerator is 1 minus epsilon 2, whereas this will be infinity. Anything divided by infinity is equal to 0, therefore F1 to 2 will become 0. Therefore, simplifying this one, heat transfer without a shield, Q1 to 2 will become 3783.2 watts. Case 2, that is heat transfer with shield. Now we will consider the shield. So now we have to find out what is the heat transfer with shield. Heat transfer between heater 1 and radiation shield 3 is given by Q13 is equal to sigma into T1 to the power of 4 minus T3 to the power of 4 divided by 1 minus epsilon 1 divided by A1 into epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by A1 into view factor F1 to 3 plus 1 minus epsilon 3 divided by A3 into epsilon 3. Here in this equation, 1 stands for the heater and 3 stands for shield. Shield is in between the heater and the room. Thus, this equation is very much similar to the Q1 to 2, where in the place of 3, there is a 2. 2 is nothing but room, 3 is nothing but shield. This equation, that is Q1 to 3, is similar to that of Q1 to 2. So, where A3 is equal to what? A3 is nothing but area of the shield. Area of the shield is also similar to that of pi d3 l, that is pi into 0.040 into 1. 040 is the diameter, into 1 is the unit length, that is A3 is equal to 0.094 meter square. Shape factor for concentric long cylinder F1 to 3 is Q1 to 3 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8, that is sigma, into 973 to the power of 4, that is T1 minus T3 to the power of 4 divided by 1 divided by 0.094, this is A1, into 1 minus 0.8 divided by 0.094 into 0.8. 0.8 in the numerator and denominator here will be epsilon 1. 1 divided by 0.094, that is nothing but A1. Shape factor 1 to 3 is 1, that is substituted here, plus 1 minus of 0.5, that is epsilon 2 here, divided by 0.125 is nothing but A3 into 0.05. So this is nothing but A3. Simplifying this one, we will get Q1 to 3 is equal to 3.43 into 10 to the power of minus 10 into 973 to the power of 4 minus T3 to the power of 4. So this will be taken as the equation 3. Now, heat exchange between the radiation 3 and the room 2 is given by Q3 to 2. Now, 3 is the radiation, 2 is the room. Sigma into T3 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 divided by 1 minus epsilon 3 divided by A3 into epsilon 3 plus 1 divided by A3 into F3 to 2 plus 1 minus epsilon 2 divided by A2 into F2, where here in this equation is 3 is a shield and 2 is room. So temperature, T is temperature, epsilon is emissivity and A is the area, and F3 to 2 is view factor or shape factor from 3 to 2, that is from shield to room. Since room is large, A2 is infinity, again 1 minus epsilon 2 divided by A2 into epsilon 2 is equal to 0. So that value will be substituted here, that is. So F3 to 1 is again 0 because it is enclosed by a large body. So shield is enclosed by a large body. Therefore, Q3 to 2 is 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 into T3 to the power of 4 minus 308 to the power of 4 divided by 1 minus of 0.05 is nothing but what? It is nothing but the epsilon 3 divided by A3 0.125 into epsilon 3 plus 1 divided by 0.125, that is A2 into shape factor 1 plus 0. After simplification, we will get Q3 to 2 as 3.54 into 10 to the power of minus 10 into T3 to the power of 4 minus 308 to the power of 4. Now, this equation Q3 to 2, this equation Q1 to 3, you can observe. So here, this T3 is unknown. Here also, the T3 is unknown. Now, equating these two equations, we will get the value of T3. Now, equating 3.43 into 10 to the power of minus 10 into 973 to the power of 4 minus T3 to the power of 4, that is equation number 3, is equal to equation number 4, 3.54 into 10 to the power of minus 10 into T3 to the power of 4 minus 308 to the power of 4. So again, solving this one, 307.4 minus 3.43 into 10 to the power of minus 10 into T3 to the power of 4, which is equal to 3.54 into 10 to the power of minus 10 into T3 to the power of 4 minus 3.18. Now, again, further simplification, 310.58 is equal to 6.97 into 10 to the power of minus 10. Now, T3 is equal to square root of 310.58 divided by 6.97 into 10 to the power of minus 10 to the power of 1 by 4. That is, T3 is equal to 817 Kelvin. Now, substitute T3 in the value in the 3 and 4. So this is equation 3 and this is equation 4. Substituting, we will get Q1 to 3 and now substituting, we will get the values of Q1 to 3 and also we will get Q3 to 2. So both the values Q1 to 3 and Q3 to 2 we will get by substituting. Therefore, Q1 to 3 is 3.43. into 10 to the power of minus 10 into 973 to the power of 4 minus T3. So T3 is this one, that is 817 to the power of 4. Therefore, Q1 to 3 is equal to 154.6 watts. Now, reduction in heat loss due to the radiation shield. So how to find a reduction in heat loss due to radiation shield? For that, we have to take in the numerator Q without shield. So Q without shield will be the maximum heat that is radiated when there is no shield. To that, in the numerator we have to take these two values, that is Q without shield, that is maximum, minus of Q with shield, that is the minimum value of radiation when shield is provided. Now Q without shield is Q1 to 2, that is from heater to the room, and Q1 to 3 is with shield, that is from heater to the shield, divided by Q1 to 2, that is again from heater to the shield. Substituting these values of Q1 to 2 and Q1 to 3, we will get 3783.2 minus 154.6 divided by 3783.2, which is equal to 95.9% of reduction. This is reduction in the heat loss when we provide the radiation shield between the heating element and the room. So this is the solution for the problem. So the next problem is like this. Emissivity of two large parallel plates maintained at 800 degrees Celsius and 300 degrees Celsius. Emissivities are 0.3 and 0.5 respectively. Find net radiant heat exchange per square meter for these plates. Find also the percentage reduction in heat transfer when a polished aluminium radiation shield of emissivity 0.06 is placed between them. Find the temperature of the shield. Now, what they have given is two large parallel plates. One is 800 degrees Celsius and another one is 300 degrees Celsius. And their emissivities are 0.3 and 0.5. Find the net radiant heat exchanger per square meter for these plates. We have to find radiation heat exchange per square meter for these plates. Also, percentage reduction in heat transfer in a polished aluminium shield, radiation shield of emissivity 0.06 is placed between them. Also find the temperature of the shield. So we need to find the temperature of the shield, that is taken as T3 is equal to question mark. So this is what they have given. To solve this problem, we'll use the equations which are as follows. Heat exchange between two large plates without radiation shield is given as, that is epsilon average is equal to 1 divided by epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by epsilon 2 minus 1, which is equal to 1 divided by 0.3. 0.3 is epsilon 1 plus epsilon 2 is 0.5 minus 1. After simplification, we will get epsilon bar as 0.230. Now, heat exchange between two large parallel plate size Q1 to 2 is epsilon average is into sigma Stefan Boltzmann constant into area A into T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4. So epsilon indicates the emissivity, sigma indicates the Stefan Boltzmann constant, A is area of the plate, T1 and T2 are the temperatures in Kelvin for plates 1 and 2 respectively. Substituting these values of epsilon 0.230 here into sigma into A into T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4, that is 0.230 into 5.67 into 10 to the power of 8 minus 8 is sigma into area A. So that is area of the plate is not given, that's for A is kept as it is, into T1, 800 degrees Celsius is nothing but 1073 Kelvin to the power of 4, minus T2, 573 to the Kelvin to the power of 4. This divided by area, Q122 divided by area, we will get 15,879.9 watt per meter square. This is heat transfer per square meter without radiation shield. See, in this problem, for both the plates, area is not given and he is asked to find out the heat transfer per square meter. Therefore, per square meter, that is heat transfer Q divided by area, will be watt per meter square. We will get Q122 divided by A as 15.87 kilowatt per meter square, or 15.87 into 10 to the power of 3 watt per meter square. Now similarly, Q123, that is heat exchange between plate 1 and a radiation shield 3, can be calculated by the similar equation which we have used in the previous session. That is Q123 is epsilon sigma A into T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4. Actually this is T3. Whereas average epsilon is equal to 1 divided by 1 divided by epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by epsilon 3 minus 1. Substituting this value here in this equation, Q123 is equal to sigma into A into T1 to the power of 4 minus T3 to the power of 4 as it is in the previous equation, whereas epsilon average is 1 divided by epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by epsilon 3 minus 1. This entire thing above 1. So 1 is in the numerator. So this is nothing but Q123. Similarly, heat exchange between radiation shield 3 and plate 2 is also given as, in the same equation, we can use the same type of equation, that is Q3 to 2, which is equal to epsilon into sigma into A into T3 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4, where 3 indicates the shield and 2 indicates the second plate. Here 1 indicates the first plate and the 3 indicates the shield, where epsilon average is equal to 1 divided by 1 divided by epsilon 3 plus 1 divided by epsilon 2 minus 1, which is nothing but Q3 to 2 is equal to sigma into A into T3 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4, which is nothing but whole divided by 1 divided by epsilon 3 plus 1 divided by epsilon 2 minus 1. So this is equation A. This is equation B. Equation A is heat exchange between plate 1 and shield 3. And equation B is nothing but heat exchange by radiation between shield 3 and plate 2. Now we know that Q123 is equal to Q3 to 2. Now equating these two equations, sigma A T1 to the power of 4 minus T3 to the power of 4 divided by 1 divided by epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by epsilon 3 minus 1, which is equal to sigma into A into T3 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 divided by 1 divided by epsilon 3 plus 1 divided by epsilon 2 minus 1. So sigma A here on the LHS and sigma A here on the RHS, both we can cancel. Therefore T1 to the power of 4 minus T3 to the power of 4 whole divided by 1 divided by 0.3 plus 1 divided by 0.06 minus 1 whole, which is equal to T3 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 divided by 1 divided by 0.06 plus 1 divided by 0.5 minus 1, which is nothing but 1073 to the power of 4 divided minus T3 to the power of 4 divided by 19, which is equal to T3 to the power of 4 minus 573 to the power of 4 divided by 17.6. So simplifying this one, we will get T3 to the power of 4 plus 0.926 into T3 to the power of 4 is equal to 1.33 into 10 to the power of 12. And further simplification of this one, we will get T3 is equal to 911.5 Kelvin. That is radiation shield temperature as T3 is equal to 911.5 Kelvin. That is 911.5 Kelvin we will get. That is the temperature of the radiation shield. Now substituting these value of 3 in the equation A or B, we will get Q1 to 3. Therefore, Q1 to 3 is equal to, that is from plate 1 to the shield 3, 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8, that is sigma, into area, into 1073, that is T1 to the power of 4, minus 911.5, that is T3 to the power of 4, divided by 1 divided by epsilon 1 plus 1 divided by epsilon 3 minus 1, which is equal to, that is per meter square heat transfer per from 1 to 3, that is plate 1 to shield 3, Q13 divided by A is equal to 1895.76 watt per meter square. Therefore, heat transfer with radiation shield is Q13 divided by A is equal to 1.89 kilowatt per meter square. This is the radiation heat transfer with the shield. Now, finally, we have to calculate a reduction in the heat loss due to radiation shield. This is nothing but same equation which we have used in the previous example. That is, reduction is nothing but ratio of Q without shield minus Q with shield divided by Q without shield. That is Q1 to 2 minus Q1 to 3 divided by Q1 to 2. That is 15.87 minus 1.89 divided by 15.87, which is nothing but 0.88 or 88% of reduction in the heat transfer or heat loss. So this shows that by providing a thermal radiation shield between two objects, we can reduce the heat loss. So in this sample, so 88% of energy or heat loss can be saved by providing the radiation shield. So with this, I'll conclude today's session and I'll continue in the next class. Thank you very much.